Global Presentation Show, Bring It On. I'm your hostess, Shin Young. This is season 4 of Bring It On, and we started out with 18 presenters from all over the world, and it was a great chance to learn about the different culture, the tradition, the history, and system that made up our colorful world. Today is our second redemption round, which means that we are only one episode away from crowning our new champion. So, let the games begin. Let's start by saying hello to our lovely judges. Well, actually not lovely because he's kind of fearful. Let's say hello to Ilya. Hi. And the mother hen of Bring It On. Let's say hello to Amy. Hi. And, oh, he's back from a short break. Let's say hello to Robin. Hi. And last but not least, let's say hello to our lovely Punita. Hi.
Hi. Good to be back.
Okay, Bring It On season 4. Welcome to the second redemption round. Three of our runner-ups from the preliminaries will face each other off for one last time. Only one ticket to the final remains. So, who will be the lucky one? First candidate, Jane from Brazil, the land of samba. And second candidate, the first African to join one of Korea's most prestigious university, Kent from Zambia. Hello, wow. Welcome back. She's also from Canada, but quite a different character from our mother hen. Maureen, hello.
Hello, it's good to be back.
Welcome all to the redemption round. I'm sure all of you are ready to face each other off for that one last time. I can feel the passion in the room. Now, speaking of passion, Brazil is a very passionate country, am I right?
Yes, very passionate.
You guys are gonna host the Olympics
this
year,
exactly.
Right?
This year we're gonna host the Olympics in Rio de Janeiro, which is a very, very beautiful city. Mm-hmm. So I think all you guys should come along.
I think we should too,
yeah,
right?
We should, yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, Brazil hosted the World Cups last year. So soccer, sports. Yes, passion, and you guys have beautiful ladies.
And men.
In Brazil.
And men.
Don't forget.
I think our Jane is being very modest because she, in fact, is a fashion model. Did you guys know that?
Really?
Yeah.
Yes.
It
super
shows.
Famous.
Yeah.
Yeah, she's a fashion model.
Yeah.
Why don't you come up and show us? Prove to us that you're actually a fashion model, a supermodel.
Oh,
come on up.
Thank you.
Do that.
Really?
I think
sure?
I can do it. Okay, music.
Come in. She's calling you.
Wow.
Oh, you want to come with me?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, feel the runway. No.
Blue steel.
And Maureen, Canada. It's a true winter sports powerhouse, am I right?
Yeah, it is. After all, we won the Olympic of 2010 in Vancouver.
Canada. Yes, Canada is the Olympic powerhouse. We are the kings slash queens of Olympic sports. Yeah, more so than Russia.
Which is not true, because Russia hosted the Winter Olympics Games in 2014 and actually won those.
Russia versus Canada. It never ends.
it ends because Canada wins.
It doesn't end there, no.
Marie, do you have anything to say to that?
No, but why don't challenge the calm down the tension with a song?
So you will sing a song for us?
Yes.
Okay, come on up.
Yes, sure. Woo!
Well, you done me and you bet I felt it. I tried to beat you, but you're so hot that I melted. I feel right through the cracks. Now I'm trying to get back. Before the cools down and out, I've been giving it my bestest. Nothing gonna stop me but divine intervention. I reckon it's again my turn to win some or learn some. But I won't hesitate no more, no more. It cannot wait. I'm yours.
Thank you, Maureen, for that beautiful song. Now, up until now, it was all fun, but it's time to start the competition. Every week on Bring It On, we have a new theme. So what's the topic for today? Let's find out. So that's the topic for the second redemption round, outdoor activities. So what kind of outdoor activities, exciting outdoor activities, are there from Brazil, Zambia, and Canada? We went out to the streets to find out what the people thought of today's item. Let's watch together.
Global interactive presentation show, Bring It On. We have our very own smartphone application so we can hear your voice. In season 4, we count the votes live in the studio so we can hear your voice better. You get to choose your favorite item.
I choose region A, Brazil, simply because I enjoy dangerous sports.
I choose A. I haven't been to Brazil for 30 years, but I'd like to go back.
I'll choose topic C because I love to see stars.
I choose A. Because of the waterfalls.
I choose A because I love outdoor activities and I'm an athlete.
I chose B because I like animals.
Un paseo por la nieve y porque se ve la aurora, el cielo, muy precioso, muy bonito.
I chose C because aurora is one of the popular theme in this thing.
Okay, so I heard some interesting comments, but for me personally, I like to stay indoors and curl up with a nice movie, hot chocolate. So I really don't have any knowledge on this topic. Judges, why don't you enlighten me?
Well, there are a lot of things to do in Russia. There is the biggest, the deepest, and the clearest lake in Russia called Lake Baikal. It's just a masterpiece of nature because
wow.
It freezes. It's a when it freezes in the winter, it's a masterpiece of freezing.
It's
so you can actually
clean.
Go there and do a lot of stuff.
Whoa.
You can just walk on the ice or you can do this skating thing on the ice, either on bicycle or on the ski.
Wow.
You can ride a bike on the
Yeah,
ice?
You can do it. It's really thick.
Driving
the ice itself is really, really thick and it's really beautiful because the water itself is really clear. So you can actually see the through the water to the lake itself.
I mean, Canada, you guys have a lot of snow too, right?
Yeah, but it's way better in Canada.
Ooh.
Yeah. Oh.
Obviously. I mean, that's a lake. Everyone has a lake.
It's the biggest, the deepest, and the clearest lake in the world.
Well, in Canada, we also have a lot of lakes. Lots of ice fishing is really fun to do as well. Skiing, snowboarding, we're well known for being the best hockey players in the world.
No, it's
and,
not.
Yes, but the new trend is dog sledding, actually. So you have a team of Siberian Ooh. Huskies that pull along a dog sled, and then you can just Whoa. Feel like the wind in your hair, and it's very refreshing and exciting at the same time. Really thrilling stuff. So you just head out with these cute little dogs wow. and then you can cuddle them after. I think it's kind of the best way to spend winter.
Yeah, that just, is kind of the best
yeah,
way.
Yeah, that is kind of the best way to spend winter.
Yeah, lie. That's the best. But just one question. Are those huskies called Siberian, not Canadian?
Canadian huskies.
So they're what? Russian huskies, right?
So, no, Canada's such an open country. We welcome people and animals from all over the world.
Still, those
so
Siberian
we just
huskies.
Want to welcome the Siberian huskies.
Okay. Whereas Russia Russians versus just block everyone. Canada. Russia versus Canada.
Canada
never
wins!
Ends in this studio. Maureen, why don't you chip in and defend Amy?
Well, it's true that we have like one of the most or biggest competition these days, which is called the Yukon Quest, where we have competition of dog sledding, and the teams actually has to go through 1,600 kilometers throughout wow. Canada.
Now, we talked a lot about winter, but Kent?
Yeah.
In Zambia.
It's time to talk about summer.
It's you know? Time to talk about summer. Yes.
Yeah. Well, as you know, I think Africa is very well known for, you know, its wildlife and, you know, the sunlight. It's really great. So we have a very good program called the Track Tour Program, which actually takes tourists from South Africa and to like Namibia, Botswana, wow. Tanzania and Kenya, and goes up to Zambia. So you can actually book through this tour package.
Which On is a almost truck?
Like, yeah, it's a trike, bus-like. Kind of, it's designed in a way where like you can actually see through the animals. Wow.
This is the way animals should be seen, not through zoos.
True that. I agree with you. Yeah.
That sounds very exciting. Thank you, Kent, for introducing that to us. And Jane, why don't we talk about Brazil?
Oh, yeah. I'm very excited because Brazil has one of the most beautiful ports in Rio de Janeiro. And you can have the bird's eye view if you try
Paragliding.
Paragliding.
Oh, I love paragliding.
Oh,
wow.
Whoa.
Whoa.
No.
Yeah.
Is he on a kayak?
Yeah. Wow. Yeah, it looks like.
So you're actually being dropped from the helicopter?
Yes.
Like skydiving.
It is.
Wow. I want to try that.
Yeah,
I think that's on everybody's bucket list. Like once in your life, you have to do these life-changing adventures. Just by listening, just by looking at all these activities actually makes me want to go out and do stuff for a change. So I'm looking forward to our presentations today, but first things first, let's go over the rules. And this is how our scoring system works. From the judges, 40%. From the studio audience, 10%. Bring it on application, 30%. And the talk back session counts for 20% of the total score. Now here on Bring It On, your opinion matters. Your vote counts for 30% of the total score. So log on to the Bring It On application and vote for your favorite item. But if you're watching us on television, voting for next week will be open. Please remember that. Now, with that said, let's start the competition. Jane from Brazil will start us off today. Her item is the Iguazu Falls activity course. Jane, you have 3 minutes, but before you start, we have a video message from your supporters. Let's watch.
Jane, I just trust your passion, so yeah, just do your best, and I'm sure you make it what you want. So, good luck.
Fighting teams! Brazil, let's go! Let's go, Brazil!
Hey!
Hello, everyone. I'm Jane de Aquino from Brazil. And today I'm going to take all of you to the south of Brazil, more exactly to Iguazu. I'm going to be your tour guide today. And I'm going to show you guys a lot of adventures. So are you guys ready? Fasten your seatbelts and come with me to one of the nature's most spectacular wonders in the world. It's Iguazu Falls. Let's go. You guys got excited after seeing the video?
Yeah.
I'm very excited. I want to go right now, right? But first things first, we need to buy our tickets, right? So follow my lead. Let's go to the ticket office. If for only $14, you'll be able to enter the park. And we're going to have a bus that's going to take us to all the terrific trails. So first, we're going to stop at the Black Whale Trail. It's considered an ecological safari where we can do snorkeling, cycling, kayaking. For about 4 hours, you are free to do all the activities. You only pay 28 hours. You're going to have a tour guide in English to show you all the fauna and flora. But if you're like our presenter that likes more relaxing, something more calm, to just enjoy the nature, we can take this boat and we can see all the jungle and we're going to fall in love with the park. But if you're an adventure seeker like me, then you want something that is going to make your heart a bit faster, right? So let's take our jet and wrap your cameras really well because we're about to get seriously wet in a full-speed boat. The water will hit the river and we are showering by the splash. So we're going to get really close to the falls, like really close, and we're going to get showers. So it's going to be a lot of fun. And it's only 43,000 won, and it's going to take us 50 minutes of pure adventure. And if you are adrenaline junkie, then you want something even more exciting, right? You can get into this 55 meters of platform where you can abseil down into the canyon and it's spread across the border of Brazil and Argentina. Now imagine you see this view by yourself. Well, not by yourself, but with a group of people. But imagine seeing this. How amazing is that? And for an even more magical moment, we're going to take a helicopter and we're going to see the beautiful Devil Throat for only $77. And we're going to see the bird eye view of the Iguazu Falls. It's a very, very magical moment. And you can join me and more 2 million tourists a year that comes every year.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Iguazu Falls, it looks beautiful. So let's take some questions from our judges. Judges.
If the price that you have, do they have like a group discount? If you're going with a lot of people, because I'm pretty sure a lot of people were not going to just go by themselves.
So. Yeah, exactly. There's a lot of companies that do tour guides. And if you're in a bigger company, a bigger group, you can have up to 20% of discount. Mm-hmm. I saw in the internet a lot of groups that they do like big family discounts for like 20% off, 10% off. It depends on the company, okay. But around 20%. Mm-hmm.
So it's economical. That's good to know. I'll take the next question.
Yeah, so Iguazu Falls must be a national treasure of Brazil, right? And you told us there is a lot of activities. So how can the government ensure that those activities doesn't harm the nature there?
Yeah, since 2001, the government makes this deal that all the activities have to be ecologically right. So there's a lot of money that goes to protect the animals, to protect the nature around. So the government is always checking to make sure the Iguazu Falls remains just as beautiful as you guys saw.
So how can they ensure that? Like, I mean, do you have some guards there that watch people when they do some kind of activities or?
Yeah, there is guides everywhere in the park. In all the activities, you're going to have a guide. You can never do anything by yourself, actually. You always have to have a guide.
Mm. Okay.
Is it located completely on Brazilian territory or does it border with other countries?
No, it's there is a part, Argentina and Brazil. But Argentina has the biggest part, but Brazilian has the most beautiful side, I would say. I visit both. And the Argentina side is very wild, but you're not able to see everything. Also, the Brazilian side has better catwalks, so you can get really close to the falls. which in the Argentina side you can't.
Can you easily cross the border? Like, can I go from Brazil to Argentina side?
Yes, you can.
Okay, so thank you. That's all the time we have for our first presenter, and now it's time to vote, the important part. Let's start with our studio audience. Studio audience, please get out your smartphones and get ready to vote. And now our judges, please make up your minds in three. Please make up your minds in three, two, one. Press the buzzer.
Now.
One, press the buzzer.
Now.
Yeah.
Come on.
That was quick.
What?
Two really? Out of four. Two votes for Jane. Let's hear why. Robin, you were first to press the buzzer.
Yeah.
That's the answer. That's it.
You were actually too quick, eager to press the buzzer. I'm starting to think.
Don't think
you voted
okay.
For other reasons besides the
It was only based on the presentation. I really liked the video, actually.
Okay, so what did you like about Jane's presentation?
The video.
That Jane was in, right?
Yeah, the video was really great. Well made. And no, like, to be honest, actually, it really made me want to go to to the Iguazu Falls, so...
With whom?
Yeah.
You have to answer that.
I think we already know.
Yeah.
You just did.
No, but it really made me want to go to Brazil, mm-hmm. And I like the fact that you put the price on the slide, too. So for each activity, you put the price right away, so it was great to see that. And. Yeah, nice video.
Why are you blushing?
Am I?
Why are you blushing?
It's kind of hot today.
Okay. What about you, Punita? Yeah.
Well, I disagree. I think the main reasons why you guys are voting is because the topic itself and not the how she delivered it. And I think the video was great. Her presentation was pretty good, but her delivery was kind of weak. And if it was maybe your first time, then I would have pressed the buzzer. But since it is your last chance to get into the finals, it was pretty weak for the second redemption round.
Okay, so two votes from our judges. What did our studio audience think of Jane's presentation on the Iguazu Falls? Here are the studio points for Jane. From the judges, 20 points. And from our studio audience, 5 points for a total of 25 points from the studio.
Well, yeah, I'm not really happy about it. I thought I would get more points, but, well, what can I do, right?
Next up is Kent from Zambia. He will be presenting about Zambia's Mukuni Big Five Safaris Interaction Program, and he is dressed to the occasion. Before we hear from him, let's check out his video message.
Don't be nervous, just enjoy it.
Kent, you always do your best, so I believe this time is not gonna be a big deal for you, and you will be the winner for sure.
Greetings, everyone. My name is Kent. But before I go ahead with my presentation, let's watch this video I prepared for you. Oh, this is Africa. Now, I'm here to introduce to you about the real Africa, Zambia. We have a lot of animals. Talk about the giraffes, you know, leopards, the hyenas. All over Africa, you're going to enjoy the view of all these beautiful wild creatures.
From now onwards, I'm going to introduce to you about the Mukuni Big Five of Zambia.
Yes. So, what's my topic today? I want to talk about the Mukuni Big Five of Zambia. The Mukuni Big Five of Zambia, it is a safari where you have, you have time to interact and walk with the wildest creatures in the world. Now, what comes in your mind when you see these pictures? I guess it's fear, right? But fear not. When you go to Mukun Big Five safaris, your fears will be healed because you're going to interact, you're going to have different kinds of activities to have close interaction with these wild natures. So Mukun Big Five safaris is located in the heart of Zambia's capital, Zambia tourism capital, which is the Livingstone, and it is about 5 kilometers away from the mighty Victoria Falls. And it is one of the few eco-friendly zoos in the world, a conservation of Africa's endangered wild species, and also it has a very good research center that help with the breeding and educating and also training wild animals like the cheetahs. So what are some of the activities you can do? Well, first is the cheetah walk. We know cheetah is like the most fastest creature in the world, so you can have a chance to interact with the cheetahs. And also you can have a chance to walk with the lions without no restrictions, no enclosures, walk around with them in the wilderness. And also elephant back safaris. You can have a chance to ride on the elephants. And some of the extra activities we do at these facilities are cheetah breeding program, volunteer program, both for locals and internationals, cheetah-run facilities, and also sponsorship for villages nearby their facility. And eco-friendly commitment is that first, all the animals are walked in the bush just to make them familiar with the wild, and also all the animals are all maintained in a free-roaming environment. And also, all the animals at Mukuni Big Five are not biochemically tamed. Instead, they are naturally trained in a wild setup. Now, life is all about adventure. You're all welcome to take a time during the summer break to visit the mighty Mukuni 7. You can ride on the elephants, interact with the lions and the cheetahs. Welcome to Zambia.
Wow. Thank you. That was a very interesting presentation. Let's go straight to our question and answer session. Judges.
Yeah, what is what makes a zoo an ecological zoo?
So I think in general, a lot of zoos, the animals are locked up in the cages, and then they all just have to be restricted in those environments. But in this case, the lions, the elephants, and the cheetahs can freely move around the whole environment and actually get acquainted with the nature. But I must have to note that there is special training that is given to the lions and animals. And eventually, actually, when they grow to a certain age where you cannot really tame them enough, then they release them to the national parks of Zambia.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So that makes it an eco-friendly...
Yes. They are not locked up in an enclosed place.
Okay.
What kind of preparation do you need to go on this safari? Do you need to get any shots or anything like that?
No, but the preparation you have to go through, of course, when you arrive at the place, you are given more of like a 31-hour orientation of how to go about with the animals. We have to remember that these are wild animals. Even if they are trained, you know, sometimes there might be some mistakes, but you are trained on where to touch, how to walk with the animals. If it's to pet them, you know, you can only pet them maybe on the forehead. You don't have to play with their teeth, you know. So
that would not be wise.
Yeah, you're kind of taught, you're trained. But because they're also trained animals, I mean, they know how to react. For instance, like when you're walking with the lions, you don't have to surpass it by running away to think maybe you're trying to play, you know, throw and catch. So it will, like, you know, come after you. So it might be, I might put yourself in a dangerous position. So kind of given a special orientation. But it's not very professional. It's not very, like, hard type of orientation. Mm-hmm. It's just simple do's and don'ts.
Training.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Well, I'm still not convinced. Like, statistical question, were there any accidents of people getting hurt in this zoo?
I've not found that any kind of accidents that have been there. But since its inception in 2005, because before 2005, actually, there has been a long period of training. There have been a lot of expertise coming in, zoologists, and people who are trained to do the animal training. But I've not heard of any accidents. If there have been any accidents, they have been very minimal. Maybe a situation where maybe people don't follow the instructions that have been given to them. But even as you walk with the animals, because it's a short kind of mile walk, you walk with the guides in case the animal maybe, you know, tries to to go away from the training. So I'm not sure of the accidents, but there have never been any recorded accidents so far, to my knowledge.
Okay, there you have it, the answer to all your questions, and it's your turn to respond. Let's vote. Studio audience, please get out your smartphones and get ready to vote. Now, our judges, it's your turn to vote. Please make up your minds in three, and now our judges, it's your turn to vote. Please make up your minds in 3, 2, 1, press the buzzer. Press the buzzer.
Again? Really?
Oh!
It's right there.
It's not gonna happen. Okay. 3 out of 4 from our judges. Amy, Robin, and Punita voted for Kent's presentation. Let's hear why. Amy.
Yeah, you know what? I like your costume. I think that was one of the reasons why I voted. I'm not kidding. We are at the stage now where we need to get creative. You need to have something a little bit special, something that we can remember you for, and I'm definitely going to remember this costume. So I appreciate it, and I think it was a great risk that paid off.
Thank you for liking my safari swag.
Safari swag!
Yo, bro.
Loving it. Okay, but Ilya, you're not sold. You're not convinced.
No, I'm not convinced. I mean, for this kind of topic, you should have brought these safety issues first on the very front point of your presentation, and you didn't say anything about safety during your presentation. You kind of mentioned it during Q&A session, but you still were not very perfect and clear with that. For me, safety is number one priority here, should be one number one priority here. So for that reason, no, that was not a very good presentation.
Okay, 3 out of 4. 30 points from our judges. Let's find out what our studio audience thought of Kent's presentation. Here are the studio points for Kent. From the judges, like I said, 30 points. And from our studio audience, 8.5 points from our studio audience. You definitely impressed most of our audience. So total score from the studio is 38.5 points.
Yeah, I think I'm very excited and at the same time humbled for the total score gained so far, thanks to the judges, the 3 judges out of 4, so it's amazing. And our audience point score also was very amazing.
Our last presenter is Maureen from Canada. Her item is Canada's Yellowknife Aurora Tour. Before we hear from her, here's a video message.
Go, Maureen, you are the best. Go, go, go.
Hey, Maureen, good luck from Canada. I know you're the best and that you're gonna be fantastic. Cheers.
Well, hello everyone, my name is Marine Bourgoin, and today I will present you a special presentation, a package trip in Canada, the land of Aurora, especially Yellowknife, which is known for being the capital of Aurora of the world. So let's get started. So first of all, an aurora happens when electrons from the solar winds are bringing into our atmosphere, and when the collision happens, it produces energy which results into lightning. To best see them, you need to be into the auroral zone, which is exactly where Yellowknife is. That means that instead of seeing the aurora from afar, you'll see them over your head. Moreover, Yellowknife has very low precipitation, so the sky is usually clear. That's why in Yellowknife, you can see aurora more than 240 days a year on average, which leaves you with 95% chances of seeing them in winter. Isn't that wonderful? Seriously.
It is.
So if you want, you can go hotel, but let me suggest you something really Canadian, the teepees. Teepees are the traditional housing of Native Amerindians here in the area, and those are heated, furnished with hot beverage and soup throughout the night, and near a lake, so what's in the sky is also in the lake. Now there's a lot of activities in Yellowknife that you can do other than seeing auroras. Let's go ahead and see them. First, auroras. Yellowknife is very known for its historic city, and you can also enjoy the landscape, do trekking, see animals, but also do dog sledding, which is a sport in Canada practiced for more than 4,000 years. But if you like fishing, may I suggest to you ice fishing, just like Aboriginal people of the area, if you can catch a fish, of course. Finally, you can go snowshoeing, which is also practiced in Canada for thousands of years, which makes it very Canadian. If you want more dynamic, you can also do snowmobiling. And all those activities are made with guides that will show you the hot spot and how to survive all skills. And for this trip, you will need to pay between $500 and $1,000 per person, which might seem expensive. But keep in mind that those include 2 nights of hotel and 3 days of activities. Now there's one last thing that you can only get in Canada in Yellowknife, and this is the food. If you're like me, you probably want to eat one of those. First one, let's take a look at those. So you can get caribous, moose, even musk ox meat, but one specialty in Yellowknife is muktak. Muktak is like a sashimi, so it's a frozen raw piece of whale. Wow. Have you ever tried?
Whale?
I'm sure I want to try that. So this was the end of my presentation. I hope I convinced you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Maureen, for your presentation. Let's take some questions. Amy was particularly loud.
That was a perfect presentation. I mean, what more could you want? Great presentation. What happens, though, if you get sick or you have some kind of medical emergency? Can you
yes,
go to the hospital?
Yes, I can talk about that for sure. Actually, Yellowknife is, I know it looks like it's lost in the north like that, but it's actually a city that's more than 20,000 inhabitants there. So they do have hospital and facilities near the hotel. And also, like, if you do the activities, all the guides have a rescue formation. And moreover, like, if you do a dog sledding or a mobile, snowmobile, you actually have to have a security kit with you all the time. So if, for example, something happened, you will get like the patch and secure on the place, and then you can be transported to an hospital.
Perfect answer.
Okay.
Well, the obvious question is, what's so Canadian about Northern Lights? Because we have it all around Russia.
Ooh. Yes, that's true. As I said in my presentation, the best place to see aurora is the aurora zone. So this is also like Russia, Norway, and Alaska, not just Canada. So the special thing about the aurora zone is that instead of seeing them from far, you see them over your head. Now, Russia has them, yes, for sure, but the tourism there is not really developed yet. As for Norway, the activity we actually propose are always snowshoeing and dog sledding, which is more of a Canadian activity. So since you want to do something with Canadian activity, why not go into Canada? And my last point is Alaska is for sure a good place to see auroras, but it's more expensive.
Boom!
Wow!
Oh. She showed you. Why you overpricing people? Come on now.
I think I've never seen Ilya speechless. That was a first. Okay, great answer, Maureen. I'm going to open up the floor to our studio audience for questions. Can I see a hand? Yes, please pass the mic.
You mentioned the history of Yellowknife. But not that much. Can you talk a little bit more about that?
Yes, in Canada, they were what we call the Golden Rush, and Yellowknife is actually part of it. So it was built mostly in 1930s, and we had a lot of gold mines there. They are now closed. The last one closed in 2004, but there's still a lot of history with anything that brings with the Gold Rush. And they're now even diamond mines. So there's a lot of activities and historical places that you can visit. And of course, some very archaeological place to see the Amerindian old sites.
Okay, well answered. Now it's time to vote. Studio audience, please get out your smartphones and get ready to vote. And now let's ask our judges. It's your turn to vote. Please make up your minds in three. Make up your minds in three, two, one. Press the buzzer. Press the buzzer. Whoa, whoa. Oh! Whoa! 4 out of 4, perfect score for Marie.
I was very, very shocked and surprised. I did not expect that all the 4 judges to vote for me, but I'm really glad they did.
Why do you look so surprised, Junita?
I think it's really surprising just to get 4 votes, especially today since Ilya didn't vote for anyone. But yeah, that's cool.
But why did you vote for Maureen?
I voted because I think you took a different route in your presentation. You didn't really have any slides, but yeah, it was all video, and you memorized a lot of your presentation lines, and it was great. I didn't have to be like, oh, this is that, you are this. You weren't like telling a different story with your presentation. It was perfect.
Actually, the same point. The way you put the video was really like creative, so that's really great, I think. It made me like concentrate on all your presentation. Not sometimes you concentrate just on what like the presenter is saying, sometimes just on the slides. And because of the video, all of it was like kind of coming together. So yeah, really great. And the Q&A too. You know your subject, so yeah, perfect, really. Perfect presentation.
What about you, Amy?
She presents like a Canadian. I mean, it was flawless. It was an excellent presentation, and I think it was a step up above what you did last time, which is even better. So who knows, if you make it to the finals, like who knows what you're capable of?
We'll have a second Canadian champion.
That would be amazing.
Okay, and you, Ilya, finally, you took the effort to move your hand and press the button.
It was a really huge step up, as Amy said, from your previous presentation. You did a great job, like, overpassing yourself in the past. You were very knowledgeable. I really, really liked your answer about that thing being Canadian, not Russian. So, obviously, there was no chance for me not to vote for this presentation.
Okay, so perfect score from our judges. Let's check out our studio audience points as well. Here are the studio points. For Maureen. From the judges, a perfect 40 points. And from our studio audience, 7 points for a total of 47 points. Good for you, Maureen. Now that's all from the studio, and 30% of the vote comes from you. So you know what I'm gonna say. If you liked the presentation, go on to our application and vote for your favorite presentation. The online vote counts for 30% of the total score. And in the meantime, our presenters will have to fight for that 20 points. Yes, it's time for the talk back. It's time for the talk back. It's a chance for our presenters to attack and fight back. Now there's 20 points on the line. 2 people can split them, or 1 presenter can take them all. Now, it's gonna be your last chance to redeem yourself if you think you're lagging behind in points. You know who I'm talking to. So, attack wisely and defend aggressively. You have 3 minutes to outwit your rivals, and your time starts now.
I have a question. First of all, I need to say something because I really like your presentation.
Yes, thank you. I really
like your delivery. But as an animal lover, I'm totally against this type of tourism. There's no such a thing as
ecologically friendly because wild animals are supposed to stay in the wild environment. We are not supposed to get close to them.
Thank you very much. But what do we do with the animals that have no parents to take care of them?
No,
this is why this facility was made to make sure that at least they provide a parental that they're lucky.
It's made from profit.
And look at it. No, it's not just about profiting. At the same time, there's more research that helps them out to train out and get used in the environment.
It says that the tourism is killing the wildlife.
So well, we should let them just suffer and be hunted in
the environment? No, but they're supposed to stay in the environment.
You say like they keep the animals and then raise them, and I'm for that, it's fine. But then you say after they will be released in the nature, which is fine too. But then, I'm not finished. Why are they, like the guide saying that you can hold the lion by the tail and walk with them and cheetah are in leash?
It's true, actually.
Is that really wild animals?
So actually, while they're there, like I said, they get them while they're shoe babies and then they train them up. But it doesn't really mean that they very much tame them that they cannot adapt to the world again when they're released. And when they're released, actually, there are some tour guides. There are some guards that actually protect them and they put
the
benefits to the local people. Actually, that's the point I had. The benefits. I wonder how the Eskimos in Canada are benefiting from this. That's where is it?
Exactly.
Because it looks like you don't really care about the indigenous people.
No,
it's all about how much money we get.
Care about
and
no,
for Brazil,
because people of
it's
Brazil,
kind of expensive.
I have a question because more people need to get a visa to go to Brazil. So
and
if
it's
I can go to Argentina, Argentina is more
Canada also, and the catwalk is nicer, so why would I go to the Brazilian side if I have 90% of the environmental friendly in this case? Canada, I'm sorry, I just don't know how much you protect the Eskimo people in the northern part of Canada. And at the same time, I don't know with how well you protect them, make sure that the waters that come from the falls are actually well clean and make sure that people
are not
treated.
Three, two, one, hands up.
Hands up. Hands up.
Hands up. Hands up. Hands up. Hands
up.
I feel that was really stressful, but I think like all of us did a really good job at like putting the asking question and like debating our own point.
Like I felt like all of us three was really like eager to win, and we were like talking to each other and like trying to solve problems. Actually, I was going through all my heart because I really believe in what I said. I really think
so. It was really great, and I think I really dominated. So I feel like I'm gonna get the extra points.
All right. Our presenters done their part, and now it's up to our judges and our studio audience to award the extra points. So judges, please huddle up, and studio audience, please make up your minds as well. All right, judges, who deserves your extra 10 points?
The extra 10 points goes to Hum. Kent from Zambia.
And why is that?
Well, I think everybody did have really strong points, but Kent did bring up the Native American issue, which I think that in itself was a different perspective, and it was a winner.
Okay, great. Now that extra 10 points from our studio audience, who did it go to? Who will it be? It will go to... Kent, congratulations.
Whoa!
So that extra 20 points all went to Kent. Now this is going to make the competition exciting and interesting. The voting has closed and we have the final results.
coming up shortly. It's time to hear the verdict. I have the final results in my hand. We've added all the points from our judges, our studio audience, from our online application, and the talk back session. Now, today is the redemption round, which means that if you come in second or third place, you will have to go home. Only the winner stands a chance to go to the finals, only if he or she has a higher score than last week's winner. So, who gets a final shot at the final round? It is today's winner is with 66.03 points is today's winner is Kent. Congratulations. Wow.
Judges, studio audience, bring it on app. Bonus point and the final score.
This isn't it. If you made it this far based on your presentation skills, now it is up to fate. Because you will only go on to the finals if you have a higher score than last week's winner, which is Melina. So, who has the higher score? It was a very close call. The person with the higher score had an advantage of 3.24 wow. points. Only 3.24 really? Points. So, who will go on to the finals? Who will get another chance at becoming a season 4 champion? Kent or Melina? Melina or Kent? So, Kent, how do you feel right now? How do you think he feels?
I'm trying to be chill, but yeah, just I'm ready for anything. Okay. This is Bring It On, so I'm just waiting for you, presenter, to bring it on. And
you made it this far. Actually, you all did. So, the person going on to the final is. Melina.
Whoa.
Yes. Melina had a total score of 69.54 points. So it was such a close race. So close. Yep. So how do you feel right now, Kent?
Well, congratulations to Melina. Mm-hmm. I've never presented with her, but I think she deserved it. And I'm very humbled actually to present mm-hmm. with these beautiful ladies here. Mm-hmm. Now standing in the middle of them, I think it's an honor. And I just wish the final contestants next week mm-hmm. all the best. And yeah,
hey, good luck. Thank you for that very humble comment. And guys, you did an incredible job. Not just Ken, but you, Jane, and also Maureen. So, it was an incredible journey. Why don't we give them a great round of applause? Survival presentation show, Bring It On each episode, three presenters will introduce and promote their home countries. Next week is the final round, and you get to choose with your vote who gets to be crowned the season champion. Next week is the final round. It was an incredible journey. I'm so excited! Woo! I'm so excited! So join us next week for the ultimate
presentation showdown. Until we introduce all fascinating items from around the world, we will continue to bring it on. Join us next week for the final round. See you next week, folks. Bye.
Bye.